We are very passionate about hope. That's our approach. So I have seen situations many, many times where people have been told that there is no hope, there is no option. And then when we took care of them, now 5 years later, 6 years later, they are walking. And the impact is unbelievable. And honestly, there is nothing more joyful than having such an impact on somebody. We created a limb salvage program here at UH because saving people's legs, it really takes a village. It's not about one individual, one doctor, one specialty. Their needs are vast. It's taking care of the wound, dealing with the infection, dealing with nutrition, making sure that we are providing them with appropriate follow-up. So we created a team, a multidisciplinary team of vascular surgeons, interventional cardiologists, podiatrists, wound care specialists, and others who work together. We are successful when we have saved the limb, the wound has completely healed, and the patients can walk, enjoy their daily activity, and they're back to normal. This idea of critical limb ischemia, or ulcers, or gangrene, PAD, vascular disease affecting the legs, is actually a huge problem. Let's say about 25 to 30% of patients over the age of 65 across the United States may have some degree of PAD. At 2 years, 50% of the patients that have gangrene or ulcer due to vascular disease die. Many of them have significant psychological consequences. They're depressed. They can't do their activity of daily living. They can't walk. They can't work. So there is a high rates of amputation in the United States for patients over the age of 65. Up to 70% of these patients did not have any major vascular workup in the year prior to their major amputation. These patients deserve a second opinion, deserve to be seen by a multidisciplinary team, and we believe by saving legs, we save lives. And we are committed in doing that. There are a lot of activities and programs that we have here that are very unique and are committed to limb salvage. One of those programs is called Limb Flow, which is for patients that have no options. These are patients that have been told that you need a major amputation, there is no bypass, or even stent or angioplasty that can be done. And we are one of the five centers across the United States. We are the only center in Ohio using these cutting-edge technologies. Our goal is to divert the blood from the artery to the vein, and by doing so, get blood to the foot and save the patient's legs. One of the unique programs that we have started here to show our commitment to limb salvage and to give patients hope is the Limb Salvage Advisory Council across the system at UH. We have doctors from all angles of limb salvage in this board. We review the images, we review the data, we review the patient's clinical history, and then collectively we agree or disagree as to whether amputation is the right thing to do. If we disagree that amputation is not a good idea, then the team decides who is most qualified within this team to now take the patient and perform the other steps. I think this is going to be revolutionary because this is one way to ensure that the patients are getting every hope and every knowledge that is available in the organization in trying to save their limbs. My advice to patients that have ulcers, gangrene, that have vascular disease is to please get a second and a third opinion. Don't take amputation for an answer.